When spring comes, my mother goes to the backyard to tend the garden. A couple of hours in the morning and evening, she would go around to pick the weeds, water the plants, mix compost collected from our kitchen to enrich the soil. If she's not in the garden, she's in the kitchen or at the mahjong table with her friends. We usually can find her at her spot in the living room. We had this garden for as long as I could remember. She would ask me to help her out in the garden, to water the plants, pick weeds, or till the soil when I was younger. But now, since I've become more busy and not as home as often, she managed it by herself. There was this moment, I can't remember exactly when, I was going through old photos, and then I realized, wow, Mom, you have really aged. You know, in my head, she is timeless, ageless, and eternal. I never heard her full refugee story, only bits and pieces. So one day I asked her, Mom, can you tell me the story?
Tao Tao.
就喺越南，媽咪慘啊！媽咪叫個公公俾媽咪去偷渡啦。點知偷渡嘅時候，咁啊媽咪個肚子大，做個腳手啊，腫曬，腫曬。啊，嗰時喺金邊坐監啊，坐咗幾年，坐咗三半年。第二次去，嗰架船撞落嗰個島嗰邊，嗰啲死屍死幾多人啊，暴喺面度。 媽咪咧，驚嗰解放軍嚟捉，媽係隔離同呢嗰啲死屍瞓埋一齊，等佢唔知道媽咪死咗，佢冇捉媽咪翻牆，嚇咁咪先偷爬翻出嚟，先去個街市嗰度病埋個街市嗰度瞓。啊，你阿爸爸偷渡去嗰陣時候，點知啊失咗蹤死咗，咁我又平我一個人喺金邊度。 生喺出嚟，佢入醫院度，我記得佢就冇錢買藥飲，冇得食，生成日都冇飯食，冇水飲，一捧你去出街市度瞓，又要揾食，又要食，幾淒涼。喺嗰個島啊，幫佢洗碗，買糖水洗碗，剝兩餐食。你瞓喺尿床度行過，得閒嘅話你唔得閒，等你一路啦。 咁我有個泰國婆，佢見你咁可憐，靚仔白淨，咩同人哋講啊嘛？叫嗰個婆啦，賣嗰個仔啦，我俾3錢金佢，你賣咗俾我啦，3兩金賣咗俾我啦，係有錢啦。我話唔賣啊！啊嗰日你唔賣，你已經都冇得食，冇得住啦，又咩都冇啦，點解你唔賣個仔咧？ 你賣咗咪冇咯，咁我唔賣，咁咪先偷渡佢。你媽死咗3至4年去，第4次喺個船度啦，啊又死，唔通又再死過？落雨啊，嗰架船咧又入水喎，咁啊我攬住你，我話喊啊，唉，始終都係死。 唔死錢都死下，都始終都係死逃過唔結。入到難民界啊，見到啲朋友啊，個個人爭住抱你，媽唔理啊！嗰時媽好攰，個個人喺泰國住咗幾年，6、7年、7、8年、10幾年都有。媽咪，lucky， 咁咪住喺菲律賓，到6個月啊，媽有名啊，去美國。
Today, we both in our own ways have moved on one way or another, and it seems like in different directions. The only time I would see my mother is in the morning before I leave, and at night, for a brief moment when I come home. Almost every day, I'm usually out, on my way to school, heading out to work, or just traveling somewhere. We spend more time apart than we do together, that we don't even know how to communicate with each other sometimes. Even though I can speak in many other languages, I can't find the words to fully express how appreciative I am that she did not give me away, that she did not abandon me on that island, that she didn't give up on the both of us. I don't want her to think that I have abandoned her. I want her to know, no matter where I am or what I'm doing, how many countries, oceans are between us, she tethers me to reality, to what's important. That closeness, that bond that we share, well, it has nothing to do with distance.